I learned such valuable lessons by traveling to Pier by Jackrabbit Bus for 3 years with the women that were breast cancer survivors. They taught me so much, I can't even explain how much they taught to me. But the first year we went to Pier was on Valentine's Day, and we slid into the governor's mansion driveway because it was sleeting rain, and I'm sure we left ruts on the road for a long time. But we went to the door, and Lyndon Nicholson graciously accepted a dozen red roses for us, and we just asked that she would come to hear the testimony of these wonderful ladies that told their story in hopes that they could make a difference for South Dakota women to have early detection of breast cancer by getting their mammograms covered by insurance companies. And we knew that Linda supported us because she came every single time there was a hearing, and we so greatly appreciated that. The other thing that really worked well for us with the legislature, which was kind of unconventional at that time, was when the ladies came to have their mammograms, I kept the voting records close at hand. And when I saw that some of them might be related to some of the legislators, I showed the voting records and them were America's friends and sons. The other thing that worked really well for us was when the State Medical Association opposed our legislature, the women called and said, "What can we do, Betty? We've got to get behind you. This isn't fair." And so they threatened to leave the medical auxiliary, and the bill passed. I would like to thank my husband Don for 49 years of love and support. He's been so gracious to me. And we are so proud and love our son and his beautiful wife Tracy so much. They have brought so much happiness to our family, along with their beautiful children, Christian, Brinley, and Emery. We are so grateful for them. And to our daughter, Lisa, and her beautiful daughters, Elizabeth and Catherine, they're remembered tonight with much love and affection. I am so grateful to Dr. Milton Lutch. He's renowned, and for some odd reason, he has supported me and been so trusting of me for many years, and I'm so grateful for that because he's really the one that taught me to teach women to embrace their own good health and to fight for what they thought was right. So I'm so appreciative of that. And then Dr. Thompson, he was so instrumental in the beginning of the Breast Health Institute because he was just returning from his fellowship in radiology training of breast imaging, and he was the first one in the state to have that honor. blessed with quality initiatives that put us on the path and really set the record down the road for the Breast Health Institute. I was also fortunate to work with some of the finest staff. I see them here, and it just warms my heart that they came tonight. And they were amazing, and everywhere I went, I received accolades from everybody about how kind they were, and they still are, to give women the best experience possible, and I'm so grateful to them. I had two wonderful, outstanding vice presidents that I reported to. And the first one was Kay Santima. She's here tonight with her husband. And I was so happy when she supported me unconditionally. And she helped get the Breast Health Institute down the path of being the first comprehensive breast program in the state. She was incredible to me. Jackie Cluck was a vivacious leader, and she taught me so much as well. She taught me to think outside the box and to look at patient-focused care, and I really appreciated that. My sincere thank you to Dr. Lauren Cheddar, who was my nominator, and he's renowned in the field of medical oncology, and I so appreciate him taking the time to make this possible, and I really appreciate all that he's done for me, along with his beautiful wife, Jean. I'm so grateful to all these people who saw something in me that I didn't see. And God has blessed me beyond my wildest dreams. Thank you.
Thank you, Vinny.